Hey everybody, Kyle here, and welcome back to more Let's Play Oddworld New and Tasty. In the last part, we made it to Paramonia, and our goal here is to go into each of these six rooms and activate the flintlocks that are in each room. So, we're going to go ahead and start over here on the left side. Okay. Now, in Paramonia, or this specific area, which I think is the Paramonian Temple, there is only one Mudokon that we have to save. So we can just keep that in mind. So the main thing in Paramonia is Paramites, obviously. Now these things are kind of gentle creatures until you back them up into a corner. So yeah, the end of this ledge is considered a corner. So if I went over there, that Paramite would probably kill me. So Paramites are dangerous when you corner them or if you find them in a group. So, yeah, this one right here would also be considered, it would kill us, is what I mean. Okay. So, yeah. In each of these rooms, there's going to be the flintlock, which is right here. There's also a bell song that we have to learn. Do we have a rock or anything? And there's also the flintlock, which we have to get. I don't know if I said flintlock twice, but, yeah. Oh, hello. Oh, gosh.
No.
Oh, gosh. Oh, my gosh. Some of these are so long. Oh. Oh, I think you have to listen to the entire thing if you mess it up. Damn it.
Okay.
Oh, man, I only missed that by one the first time. Okay. So, first thing you need to do is go up there and get that chant, or that circle. I forget what they call that. Oh, gosh. Okay. So we're gonna have to get this. Alright. Okay, that makes it a little awkward. Okay. Yeah, you need to get that power circle. I'm gonna call it power circle. The chant ring, whatever. And you need to blow up those mines. What's this say? Blow. Bombs. With spirit rings. Okay, spirit rings. Thank you, Random Lights, for teaching me the way. Okay, so you need to get spirit rings to blow up those bombs so that you can activate the flintlock. And there's still something we need to do. Let me see. Oh, we have to go up further. Duh. That well's not activated yet, so we can't do much with that. We got more bombs up here we can blow up. Okay. And we can get some meat. Now you can use meat to distract the Paramites. So that's something to keep in mind. So you can also use it to lure. Wait, is that what that says? Do not forget the flintlock. Yes, we know that. Thank you. Okay, yeah, so we could actually use meat to lure Paramites to specific areas. For example, we can throw meat over there, the Paramite's gonna go after it, and now we can get over here to the bell song. Okay, so that is that. Yeah, the Paramites will leave you alone as long as you don't corner them, and as long as there's not more than one in one area. Okay. So, whoa. Yeah, you need to hurry up and get on that ledge when you first get up there, or else you'll get killed by the Paramites. So, unlike in Abe's Exodus, you can't possess the Paramites, and you couldn't in the original game either. But possessing Paramites and playing as them in Abe's Exodus is pretty fun, because you can command a little squadron of them, and it's pretty sweet. Okay, so moving on to the second one here. What do we got? I hear a slig. I hear a dirty, stinking slig. And we probably need to possess him. But he's not far enough over here. Oh, gosh. Okay. Yes, run this way. Okay, or not. Hello? Are you gonna come over here so I can possess you? You're too far away, bro. Oh, gosh. Yeah, if I get hit once, I'm dead. Oh, come on. See me. Oh, okay, when they do see me, they just shoot. Okay, so this is awkward. Let me see. Woohoo! Yes, come this way, please. Okay, so... Ah, this game is far from perfect, but I still like it. Come here, guys. I need you to come here. Oh, yes, thank you. Okay. Alright. That was annoying. Okay. So, yeah. You need to kill those sligs before you can proceed. And now this room actually gave me a little bit of trouble, and I do remember this, because I also came here with only one health, which is what I have now. And unfortunately, sometimes there's a bat. Okay, there it is. And the bat, yeah, that was the bat that killed me right there. So, oh gosh. You have to time this so that you don't get hit by the bat. And, okay, there we go. That was not too bad. Yeah, the bats do a little bit of health, or a little bit of damage, a little bit of health. So yeah, and if you only have one little bit of health left, you're probably gonna get killed by the bat. But anyways, we have the bell song and the flintlock here. But we gotta blow up that slig first. Oh, and there was birds there. So those birds will actually give us health, and I'm pretty sure I've mentioned that before. Okay, so we'll wait for those birds to come back so we can get a little bit of health. Awesome. Heal me, please, birds. Thank you. So that means we'll have a little bit easier of a time here with the bat. Okay. So I'm back down to one health, but at least I survived the bat. Alright, so next thing, gotta blow up these mines here. Okay, and that's it for this secret. Or not this secret, but this room. We got the flintlock, we got the bell song. Awesome. Oh, I like how they did that. Okay. What did Abe say when the bats first came? He looked at the screen and said something, but he died. I mean, the birds went away before. I can hear what he said, I guess. So yeah, I like what they did with the bell song. They did a pretty cool job with those, graphics, I guess. Those graphics, man! Okay. So we have a little switch here that makes rocks fall. What else do we have? We have a Paramite that's curious. And yeah, we can't get over there until we take care of him. So, okay, Mr. Paramite. Oh, gosh. So he's actually going to make rocks fall. And I may or may not have messed this up. Oh, gosh. Fucking Paramite, man. Alright, thank you. Now, I know that there's another Paramite around here, maybe. Where did that other Paramite go? Hey, now you can follow me. I feel kind of bad. Such a majestic creature getting killed just so that I can get through this. Okay. So, it's probably a good idea. I technically killed myself doing that. Okay. So we need that bell song, and I'm actually glad that I messed that up, because I would have forgot this and proceeded, and I would have been even more messed up. Oh, what a beautiful song for the bells. Yeah, probably not the preferred way to go is by killing yourself with, rocks. Making rocks fall on your own head by stepping on a switch, and then immediately stepping where the rocks fall. Okay, so we've opened the door, but we need to get the flintlock still. And the flintlock is actually right up here. Okay, now you want to be careful, because as soon as you pull that, there will be a bunch of paramites that come. Ah! Okay, that one always gets me, that last one. Okay. Yeah, so you have to be careful. There we go. Oh, damn it! So. Yeah, this one is really annoying. Yeah, so I think you just have to run until there's no more paramites. Okay, I think I got them all. Alright. So that one took me a lot longer to do the first time, because I couldn't get over, like, the paramites getting close to you and making rocks fall on that spot where you can, like, jump up onto that ledge. Okay, on to the next one. Three more to go. Okay, so here's the exit right here. And we got swinging balls of death. We got birds. I'm okay on birds for now. We got fucking... We got bats. Alright. Lots of bats. It was like I belly flopped down into the hole. Wait, come back, bird. I need you. Okay. Well, alright. So... Whoa. I forgot to push the jump button. Alright, oh gosh. Fucking... I don't want to get killed by the bat again. Alright, what do we got here? We have a mine, which means... I might need to activate that so that... something can get blown up by it, maybe. And I'm assuming I need to stop these mines so that I don't get blown up by those. Alright, we got the flintlock there. And we have Slig. Okay. So there's our bell song, and I feel like I maybe needed to stop at least one of those mines that were back there. I think I can do this. Well, alright, let's try this. Alright. Yes, okay, I think we've got it, because now I should be able to make that jump, and then the Slig will be killed by that other mine that I left activated. Alright, here we go. Oh, he fell down. And he landed on that mine, okay. So it all worked out. Everything is cool, now I just gotta get past the bats again. Yeah. Stay away. Nothing good can come of bats, except for Batman, but I hate Batman, so never mind. I don't hate Batman. I'm not a big superhero fan. I guess I just don't care for it that much. Anyways. Okay, moving on. You do know, Abe. Don't act like you're clueless. Alright, so moving on to this one. Now, the very last one that we're going to do is the one with the secret. So we'll do that in just a second. Okay, so immediately we got a Paramite. And there's the flintlock. There's the meat. Alright. Now, you want to be careful here because I think there's another... Okay. Couple of paramites there. Alright. Well, I think the best thing to do is not activate that, those paramites yet. I may have actually really messed myself up. Or not. I guess we'll see what happens. Okay. So, we still need the flintlock. What's this do? Oh, we got a boulder! Alright, and actually I lied. The secret is... Oh, okay, yes. The secret is in this one, and it is down here. Right? Or not? I swear it... Okay, maybe it wasn't. I hope I'm not wrong on that. Okay. I think everything's good. I'm pretty sure I didn't miss the secret. I don't think the secret's in this area. But the secret is after another part where you do kill a bunch of paramites with a boulder. So I'm assuming it's not this one. Now, what is over here? Okay. Where's this put us? Aha! So there's the flintlock. We've got the bell song. Now we just need to open up the exit door. And that's back where we activated all those paramites. So we're going to have to go back there. Let's see. Oh, hey, whoa, okay, we're good. Yeah, now there's going to be tons of paramites. But what you can do is lure them all with meat. And they'll go through the meat pretty quick. Hey, whoa. Ah, damn it. See, I may have jacked this up a little bit. Well. Go for the meat. I'm not that tasty. You want the meat? Okay. So probably the farther we can throw that, the better. Let's see. So... Oh, whoa. Alright, here's what I'm thinking with this. So, I need to save some meat for when I get close to those other paramites. So, throw some right there, we'll throw some right there. Okay. What? Okay, if I had just jumped there, it would have been okay. Go for it. Meat. Oh, okay. Alright. That worked out better than I thought it would. Okay. So we're good. You just have to distract the paramites with meat. They are easily fooled. Okay. So that's it for this one. We've got one more left to go. And there should be a secret in that one. And if there's not, I'm going to be a little upset because we probably would have missed the secret. Okay. Game? Okay. Phew, that loading took a while. I thought the game had froze or something. Okay, what do we got? One paramite here. We got honey. Which probably means we're gonna have bees. There's the bell song right away. Okay. Now, we can't go down this way because that paramite's there. And if we corner him on that ledge, he'll kill us. So, we need to head up first. I do believe the secret... Okay, yes, we do have another thing here. Oh, okay, well. So, let's not go that way yet, because we know there's multiple paramites. Got multiple paramites here as well. And we've got rocks. Well, you know what? If I get these guys too close together, okay, yep. Let's see. So we need to find a way to lure those Paramites onto that spot where the rock drops. So... I think that's how you're supposed to do it. There's a rock up there that needs to be brought down. Oh, okay, there we go. We did it. All right. And the rock's going to kill all of those Paramites. Good. And if we come in over here, there's the secret. All right, so we are good as far as secrets go. And let's see what kind of fun awaits us in this one. Alright, we've got grinders, we've got Paramites. Immediately Paramites. Alright. So that turns off the gate. Or no, that turns on the grinders, rather. Alright. Oh, not this one. Okay. This one is hard. Okay. So here's what you need to do. You've got to get past these grinders. Alright. And then also, be careful about the Paramites. They should get grinded. Oh, well. Okay. We're good. Alright. So that's it for that one. Alright, we're good. Woo! Yeah, when grinders are that close, it just... I don't know, it's kind of difficult. And I think the movement controls in this game are based on like an analog kind of thing. So, do I still have my meat? Yeah, I do. So, yeah, your movement's a little weird. Anyways, so... Let's see. Yeah, go get the meat. Good Paramite. Come on. Oh, hey, whoa. Alright, so we'll just drop some meat right there. And it wasn't close enough. There you go, buddy. Alright. So, yeah, what I was saying about the... do I not have the bell song yet? Okay, I don't think I have the flintlock. Or do I? No, the flintlock is still downwards. Okay, anyways, so what I was saying is that the grinders in this game, when you only have like one spot to get past them, it makes it a little hard in this game because the movement is like analog, but on the PlayStation 1... Okay, yeah, on the PlayStation 1... You push the button once and you moved one space. So you pushed a button on the D-pad and you only moved one space, but in this game, you roll a little bit. I guess unless you just push the button once. Anyways, that was kind of a weird way of phrasing that, but, you know. Okay, so there is the flintlock. We have some bees, which, ah, shit. Run! Oh, gosh. Okay. So what were they... Were they going after the bees? Were they going after the meat? I'm gonna assume it was the meat. Okay. But yeah, okay, so that's our last door done. We've got the flintlock, we've got the bell song. We jumped off a cliff. Okay. Yeah, go get it. Alright. There we go, let's try this again. Of all the ways to die in this particular area, falling off a cliff is not how I thought I was gonna go. Alright, so let's go ahead and leave this area and see what awaits us next. So we're gonna have ourselves a classic Paramite run coming up in a second. So yeah, the door is this way. Yep, we're good to go. Alright, so when you have all the flintlocks, this door that's on top here that was previously shut, it should be opened. And let's see what we have. Paramonia Nest. The ape soon to learn how formidable his favorite pies can be. Help him survive. Help him to see. Okay, scout from afar. Alright. So you can actually go into this well here, and you can go ahead and see what you're going to have to deal with up ahead. So we're basically going to be running from a lot of Paramites. Let's see. No Paramites so far. Well, there's some down there in the bottom right. Okay, we got a door. So this looks pretty big. But maybe we'll be okay. Okay. And there's a couple different wells that take you to a few different places. So, let's see. Alright, that just takes us back. Whoops. Alright. So I think we're ready to begin this. Now, a while back I did a Let's Play of Oddworld Abe's, or Munch's Odyssey, rather. And during a level titled Paramite Run, I played the Benny Hill theme because it kind of fit with Abe running around with a bunch of Paramites following him. So I think to kind of pay homage to that a little bit, I'm going to do the same thing with this. Although it probably won't fit as well. But anyways, no one's probably going to get the reference, but I think it'll be funny. So here we go. Harsh lessons of Paramites would soon sear his flesh. Now he's something about this mess. Okay, so that's it. Whoa, those are some spooky eyes. I don't even want to know what's in there. Okay, so yeah, that was the Paramite run. Pretty anticlimactic, but I'm pretty sure it was harder in Abe's Odyssey. Okay, so now we're being shot up. And let's see, nothing over here. Okay. So we should be getting to the end of the Paramite area. Oh, this looks pretty end of area-ish.
The Big Face said I'd learn much through my quests. This hand scar would help me, for more dangers await. I would need its full power to complete my fate.
Okay, so we have a destiny. And now we have a scar in our hand in the form of a Paramite. Okay, so that's it for Paramonia. Now we still have to go through Scrabania, which is the second area that we need to go through in order to unlock Abe's full potential. So that area is right over here. Alright, so Paramonia is complete, and now we need to go through Scrabania, but we're going to start that in the next part. So thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please feel free to like, subscribe, and do all that other good stuff. And I will see you guys next time when we continue through New and Tasty. See you guys then.